Welcome to another episode of Hotish. It's me, Starr, and today the tea is piping hot, okay? And that's not the only thing that's piping either. You'll understand what I'm referring to. Yes. Okay, let me just check that. I did put that. Sorry, guys. Welcome to the show. Just, obviously, always a couple of... I see you, TC Jess. Yeah, I know. Obviously, always a couple of little situations. Nope, it's here. How's it sound? Is that good? Is it too loud? Let me look. Let's see. Input. Let me put Yeti. It was on default for some reason. How's that? Better? Check. Check. Okay. Okay. We are ready. Oh, okay. Hold on. Let me see that. Let's see. Yeah, it is. It's Yeti. Mm-hmm. It's been there. Yeah, no, that's been there. I always saw that. Oh, Sweet Cider, you said the audio is a bit loud. Hopefully it's better now. I think it should be better now. Right, guys? I think it's better. We should probably, let's redo the countdown. We're going to just start the show right over. Oh, what's going on? Welcome to another episode of Hotish. It's your girl Star, and today the tea is piping hot. Now, that's not the only thing that's piping either, too. You're going to understand what I'm referring to in just a bit. Now, not only did the Biebs get denied here in New York City, but we are going to tell you who was crowned the greatest hip-hop artist of all time. Plus, I'm going to recap whatever else you may have missed this week. And if you're new here, well, I want to say welcome to the party. It is time to dish your Hotish. Now, I know you want to know what's trending, right? Well... Johnny Depp has been keeping busy after celebrating his victory from last week. Now, for starters, he's officially on TikTok, and you can find him at Johnny Depp, of course. Now, he just hit 10 million followers, and he posted his very first TikTok. We're going to take a look. Happy. Like, he's been seeing everything that's been going on TikTok now officially, because you know he's catching up on all the dirt that everybody was saying over the past couple of weeks, right? Now, also last week, rumors were surfacing that he might get casted for the movie Beetlejuice 2. Now, for over 30 years, you know that movie's been rumored to get a sequel, right? And we all know that Johnny's really good friends with Tim Burton, so it does sound pretty believable. By the way, if you look up the IMDb description for Beetlejuice 2, ironically, it was just updated, adding that there will be a potential 2025 release date. You know, I really hope this is true because it's a long time coming. We all grew up watching Beetlejuice, so you know we're pretty much long overdue for part two, right? Well, just when we thought Nick Cannon was celibate and done having babies, the news just broke that he is expecting baby number 9. I guess the positive way of looking at this is he's not having it with a brand new baby mama. Now, do you remember Abby De La Rosa? She's actually the baby mama who popped out his twins last year. Well, she's pregnant with, I think, just one baby this time around. Now, of course, she made the announcement on Instagram with this post, and she captioned it with the question, "Another set of twins?" Huh. Well, she sure knows how to market herself, because she continues by saying, "Follow me on OnlyFans to find out more. Link in bio. I'll be posting all the exclusive content and answering the questions y'all are dying to know." Can you just tell me what we're dying to know? I mean, it's clear you and Nick had sex and there's a bun in the oven and he's confirmed it. So what else is it to know? What else is there for us to know? Seriously. Listen, if you are really that invested, then you're going to have to pay to subscribe to her page. What a way to monetize the pregnancy. Now, As for you, Nick, again, you thought with the wrong head, okay? Sweet Cider, you think they could go for baby number 12? I don't know if Nick has in his mind that he wants to have a specific amount of kids, but this is really getting out of hand. Really getting out of hand. Ooh, Eco, Dylan, hello. Are you new here? I haven't seen you. I think you're new here. Welcome to the show. So you had no idea that there was a second movie of Beetlejuice coming out? Yeah, I know, because it hasn't really been talked about. If you go to IMDb, then I could hear the background. I hear that. Okay, that was Nasu. We're gonna... Nasu! Messing up the stream! But thank goodness we're not... Oh. Well, thank goodness that we aren't... we're not talking about a story right now. No, we don't need to retake. We're just talking to the chat right now. Yeah. So about the second movie coming out. Because here's the thing, Eco. It's not coming out till like 2025. So if you go to IMDb, then you'll see like a whole little breakdown of it. Like they're writing about it. So basically they just added that date. So there was never a date on there before. So that's really what it's coming down to. So yeah, so that's pretty much the breaking news. Oh, it is your first time catching me live. Thank you. Well, should I call you Eco or Dylan? You let me know which one's better. What up, Pogi? How are you? Yeah, I mean, listen, yeah, he can provide for his kids, but how many kids are we talking here? And I don't think that he's going to be stopping anytime soon either, FYI. I just had to throw that in there because I truly have a feeling that celibacy is just not, it's not for him. He was celibate for a month and he thought that was a long time. Mm-hmm. Anyway, let's just keep it moving. Oh, snap. Okay. I just heard that Jada Pinkett Smith wants to have Chris Rock and Will Smith reconcile on her Red Table Talk show. Now, has she lost her damn mind? Because it doesn't matter anyway. I mean, Chris is just not interested. Okay. He's too busy touring. He's getting ready for his comedy special. Where does she get off trying to capitalize on Chris's humiliation? The audacity. Seriously. I'm done with it. I'm done with them. I'm just done with them. I can't be bothered. Kim Kardashian really testing out Pete's stepdaddy skills. Now she let him bond with the kids. And in fact, you ready for this? He took her older son Saint the other day out shopping alone, just the two of them. Now they were seen holding hands and heading to grab food at the Cheesecake Factory. And I'm surprised that we have not seen World War III because we know Kanye was very clear about not wanting Pete around his kids. And by the looks of it, he's not getting his way. So I'm pretty shocked that we haven't felt like an earthquake or some kind of rumble because Kanye is probably having a tantrum somewhere and definitely just, I don't know, stomping his feet and going crazy. That's what I think. I don't know what to say. I don't even know what to say on this. Kanye, actually, I was reading earlier though that Kanye is a little heartbroken over the fact that they're bonding and I don't blame him. But then again, where was he all this time when he could have been bonding with his own kids? Instead, he wanted to move into Wyoming and leave the kids and Kim behind. So you know what? This is his own problem. All right, I'm done. I'm done on my rant. Wait, Jansen, how are you? You didn't know it's a group of VTubers? Do you like that? What do you mean by that? Let me know what you think. I mean, hopefully you are going to enjoy it. Hopefully you're going to tell your friends and hopefully you're gonna, you know, come back every week when we stream live. I mean, we're always streaming. We have a whole bunch, like you said, a bunch of streamers, but if you want to come to this show, obviously you got to come back next week. Anyway, we're gonna keep it going, right? So I guess that Kanye might actually be too busy with his own personal life because rumors broke yesterday that him and his Kim K lookalike girlfriend, Chaney Jones, broke up after 4 months of dating. In fact, TMZ was reporting that the birthday boy, yeah, today is Kanye's birthday, that he might have already moved on because he was seen on a movie date with an OnlyFans model by the name of Monica Corgan. By the way, Monica's not new, okay? She's actually been on and off with him in the past. But here's the kicker. Chaney put up an Instagram story montage today of the two of them, and she wrote, "Happy birthday, baby." She put the black heart emoji and even wrote, "I love you." Now, let's just think about this for a second, okay? Either she's getting played, she doesn't care, or like the rest of us, we always think that maybe she's getting paid to portray his girlfriend. I mean, we saw how long things lasted with Julia Fox, right? And apparently I heard that there was a contractual deal. So I don't know. Maybe Kanye's in limbo and he's deciding if he wants to renew his contract with Chaney. I mean, whatever we call it, I'm going to say I wouldn't be surprised if by tomorrow those breakup rumors are back on. Because we all know Kanye can't make up his mind, right? I mean, facts. Jeez. Thank you, Pogi. Thank you for being like my little moderator in here and letting everybody know. You are awesome. Speaking of breakups, Shakira and her longtime boyfriend, soccer player Gerard Pique, they have split after 11 years. Now, he reportedly moved into a bachelor pad 3 months ago after he was caught cheating with a 22-year-old nightclub hostess. Okay? I mean, shocking, right? Now, she released a statement saying, "We regret to confirm that we are parting ways for the well-being of our two children, who are our highest priority. We ask that you respect their privacy." Come on, man. Who in their right mind cheats on Shakira? Or maybe what I should be asking is, why did he never marry her after all this time? I mean, I guess she would sing about how her hips don't lie. That was probably the only honest thing in that relationship. Man, I feel so bad. Another devastating breakup, Lori Harvey and Michael B. Jordan. Didn't see that one coming either. Okay, they just called it quits after 18 months. And although they've both been heartbroken, and that's what they're supposedly saying, sources are initially saying that they still love each other. But I think that those sources could be wrong because she just went and deleted all the evidence that she ever dated him from her Instagram page. Okay. Now, she's also been doing the only thirst trap pictures on her stories. And you're going to ask yourself, all right, why did they end things? Well, ever since last month, there were rumors that were swirling that he was cheating on her at the Cannes Festival. And I'm pretty sure she realized her worth and decided to cut that cheater loose with the quickness. Because, you know, just because he's got the title of sexiest man alive, that doesn't mean that it gives you a free pass to do whatever you want. Michael Betrayer Jordan, is that what the B stands for? Maybe bitch ass? I don't know. Keep it moving. Goodbye. Just when I thought he was cute, I'm over it. If he's a cheater, bye. Or in the words of Cardi B, bye-bye, bye-bye. Wait, what was she, how is she doing it? Bye. Oh, I know you guys saw that last week. You definitely saw the video. I know Nasu was obsessed with the Cardi B video last weekend. And I'm sure she's probably laughing right now. Or maybe not. She's chilling. She's just chilling. Anyway. Wait, that is true. Yes, Dario. Yes, yes, yes. He is 10 years younger than Shakira. And, you know, I was going to bring this up, but I didn't want to be too worried, so we'll just talk about it here. But the fact that he was younger than Shakira, okay? And then all of J-Lo's boyfriends are always younger than her. But look at these hot chicks. They are hot. And where do these men think it's okay to go and cheat on them? You should be grateful that you have this stunning, banging woman of such a caliber. But whatever, men are dumb. I like that TC just betrayer. Yes. I know. I'm sorry I went in hard on him, Leo. I had to, because you know what? I don't tolerate that. I just don't tolerate it at all. Once you get to know me, you know that I'm tough like that. Anyway, let's keep it moving. Justin Bieber, he just got denied the other night at Carbone, which is one of the hottest restaurants here in New York City. Now, him and Haley and their little entourage, they showed up to the hotspot right after his concert to, you know, go get their eat on, and they literally got treated like us regular people. Talk about being humbled. Now, first things first, you need a reservation to get into that place. And on a primetime night, I'm telling you right now, there are no tables available, and no amount of money in the world can pay somebody off. Because when there's no table and no availability, where are you going to sit? On the floor? Anyway, I guess this just goes to show you that they won't even bend for A-listers. So they ended up rolling into Cipriani, which is also another high-end exclusive restaurant that's here in New York City. Another one of my faves that I hang out at too. Just a few blocks away from Carbone, and they got right in, of course. Now, what's even funnier is one of my friends happened to be there that night. And I was going through Instagram. They posted the video on the story. I saw Justin, I saw Haley, I saw the whole crew. Little did I know, though, that he had just been denied somewhere else. But I will say, Carbone is one of those places that you need to check out at least once. I mean, this is the deal. You got to prepare to book that reservation at least a month in advance. Make sure you get the spicy rigatoni because that's what everyone gets when they go. Because I will say, it is pretty good. And you never know who might walk in. It is the celebrity hotspot. Well, one of here in New York City. Jansen, I know there are a lot of celebrity couples that are breaking up. I don't know if it's a trend or I don't know if it's in the air or I don't know if it's in the water, but something's going on. Yes, Leo, I do notice Shakira does look the same. She does. She looks so young. She looks so good. I agree, Sweet Cider, after the first, well, I think even before the first baby, you should marry her. It's Shakira. Why wouldn't you have wanted to put a ring on that right away? 11 years later, and now you want to walk away? Goodbye. Anyway, J-Lo's documentary, Halftime, is premiering as we speak at the Tribeca Festival. We're going to show you a little clip from the trailer.
Part of being a great performer is being aware of whoever's around me right there. You feel me? It's not just about if you're getting off with the step. It's about if we're getting off with the step.
Yeah.
I don't just go, has the camera got me? But I'm also saying that the camera got me. Because I can do all of that at the same time. Yeah. I live, they said.
Diva.
Serial bride.
How do so you we can feel just about
cut it? Here.
Do you think you'll be nominated for an Oscar?
I mean, I hope so.
We can cut it. We can cut it. Okay. Well, well, well. If you liked what you saw, of course, you could go watch the entire premiere video on YouTube. Or if you liked what you saw, you could actually catch it streaming exclusively on Netflix next week. That's when it's going to be out. But of course, if you want to go watch that trailer, feel free. Lizzo and her boyfriend are red carpet official. Woo! You know, after keeping him under wraps for like ever. I mean, they were seen on Valentine's Day, but we didn't know anything about him then, okay? Nobody knew anything, but that's about to change because finally we know a little bit about this mystery man. His name is Mike Wright. They actually go way back. They were co-hosts for MTV's Wonderland back in 2016. He's known for being a stand-up comedian. He grew up in Detroit and he also is a musician. So they can both bond over their love for music. Not to mention he's also a designer for a Detroit-based luxury clothing brand. And we know she just dropped her Yitty line. So this might be a match made in heaven. I'm happy. Good for her. Yay, Lizzo. We love you. Hi, Lisa. How are you? You're in New York too. Awesome. Thank you so much for joining. So glad you're here. Sweet Cider, I see you. Wait, why did you retract a message, Sweet Cider? Why? I want to see everything. You can't retract messages in my chat. Everything needs to be known at all times. We're going to move on to a little bit of music news now, okay? Hope you guys are ready for that. Hope you guys are having a good time. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe. If you're new here, thank you so much for joining. I need you to subscribe to the page. This way you know exactly when we're going to be going live and you can be part of the live chat and hang and chit chat and all that good stuff. All right, we're going to kick into that music news now. Surprise, surprise, our favorite boys of BTS are celebrating their 9th anniversary by performing their new album, Proof. It's happening on Monday, June 13th. Now, they also have another surprise for us. They're going to be having a special guest joining them. And now the question is who? I mean, there are so many possibilities. Could it be someone that they recently collaborated with? Maybe it could be someone they plan to collaborate with on the new album. Who knows, right? But of course, the BTS Army Super Sleuths, they're going crazy trying to figure it out. Anyway, this is the info on how you can catch them on their live stream event. We have it up on the screen. It will be on their official YouTube channel. Mariah Carey, woo! She is being sued for $20 million over her hit song, All I Want for Christmas Is You. Now, let me explain, okay? There's a country music singer. There's a country music songwriter. His name is Andy Stone. He claims he wrote a song 33 years ago for the group Vince Vance and the Valiants. And he titled it All I Want for Christmas Is You. Okay. Now, he said the song charted 6 different times back in the 90s on the Billboard Hot Country Songs chart. And he even goes so far as to claim that Mariah intentionally stole it after seeing all of the radio play that it got back in December of 93. Now, she ended up dropping her version the next year, and now he wants to get paid. Is this guy for real? I mean, do you know how many songs share the same title? Not to mention her song isn't even a country song. So this guy doesn't even have a leg to stand on. Plus, why would you wait 33 years to do this? I don't know. I smell something fishy. TC Just, I know, 9th anniversary of BTS, right? I didn't think they were together that long. When I saw that, I was like, 9? I thought maybe it was like 5 or 6, at least. 9 is a lot. That's a lot. Thank you, Lisa. I appreciate that. I'm glad you like it. I hope you tell your friends. Make sure you tell your friends, share the link, let them know. And that's how we grow. I just came up with that on my own. Anyway, keeping it going. We have talked about some of the greatest hip-hop artists of all time on this show, right? Now, I came across a list of albums that Rolling Stone magazine just put out. They are ranking the greatest hip-hop albums of all time, okay? Now, here we go. Topping the list, the Notorious B.I.G., Ready to Die, followed by Outkast, Stankonia. Let me just do that part over. Followed by Outkast, Stankonia. It's like a tongue twister. Jay-Z's The Blueprint. Public Enemy, It Takes a Nation of Millions to Hold Us Back, and then Kendrick Lamar's To Pimp a Butterfly. Now, Kanye and his album, My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, right behind in 6th place. Okay, we're gonna keep it going here. Followed by Missy Elliott with Miss E, So Addictive. Wu-Tang's Enter the Wu-Tang, A Tribe Called Quest with The Low End Theory, and Lauryn Hill's The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. Wow. So you're telling me only 2 women made the top 10. By the way, Cardi B, Nicki Minaj, Lil Kim, and Meg Thee Stallion, they did make the list, but not in the top 10. In fact, how about this? Here's a little dirt for you. Cardi's album, Invasion of Privacy, came in at number 16 out of 200. And the hip-hop fans are furious right now because they are losing their minds, saying that they put her in front of legends like Dr. Dre's The Chronic, Tupac, All Eyes on Me, even in front of Nicki Minaj's Pink Friday. Listen, with all due respect, everyone's great in their own way, okay? Clearly, these artists have all sold billions of albums, so can't we just embrace all the talent as a whole? Why does everybody get so mad? Jeez. TC Juz, Where's Vanilla Ice with Ice Ice Baby? Because that's just a song. We're talking albums here, like straight up whole albums, not just the song. But would you really consider that hip hop? I wouldn't consider Ice Ice Baby a hip hop song. I would say it's more of a pop song. But like I said, as long as we all embrace everyone's talent, who cares? Anyway, moving on. Remember last week I was telling you about how pissed Lil Nas X was when he found out that he didn't get any nominations for this year's BET Awards? Well, he decided to go off on them by making this diss track. It's called Fuck BET. Let's check it out.
Yeah, fuck BET. Yeah. Fuck BET. Yeah. Fuck BET. Yeah. Fuck BET. Yeah. 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 Hey. Yeah. Look it on up. Slip it. We can stop it. Okay. Look at how I talk shit. Bitch, I should put like 3 up in the top 10. And I don't need nobody. I just need these CCs on my body. Everything I do, bitch, right or wrong, gon' make a profit. Read about it. I don't even gotta sing about it. I work all with the money that you niggas dream about. She's all on my left. She's all on my side. They don't want it like that. She's all on my left, she's all on my side. They don't want it like that, they want me to die. Don't try me, you better say that shit for somebody else. Don't try me, cause bitch I can't be late to the party. You know we got a honey inside this bitch, a honey stick, a honey.
First of all, how did he even come up with something like this so fast? I mean, good for him. I guess when you're that angry, anything will come out. But of course, BET responded by listing all of the times that he was featured and nominated for the BET Awards and also said, no one from BET serves as a member of the voting academy. I call that a typical cookie cutter safe statement to say, because I mean, question is he overreacting or do you think that he should have been nominated? I mean, I will say that Montero was really off the chain, but it's not like he's the first or the last artist to ever be snubbed by an award show after putting out a sick album. I don't know. Maybe him and The Weeknd should collab on something since he's still bitter about not being included in the Grammys. Jeez, get over it. What are you going to do with those awards anyway? They're just going to collect dust on a mantle. Like, you really care? I don't understand. Demi Lovato just announced a tour lineup for the first time in 4 years to promote their new album, Holy F. In fact, Demi is going to sound a little different than you remember. They're bringing back those pop punk roots starting in August, which is just in time for when the album drops. So you could be on the lookout for that August 19th. PC just, no, he does not like BET. He's bitter and mad because he wasn't nominated. It was like, this is the first time it's happened. Why? You know what? If it happens like a few years in a row, then be mad. But stop. Go take a chill pill. Relax. Have a drink. Maybe he hasn't had a drink in a while. I don't know. All right, we're moving on to some chick chat. Starting this Friday, you might want to keep your eyes in the sky when you're out and about really late at night, because you might get to see the rare five-planet alignment that we're going to have. Now, check this out. Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn are all going to be aligned in their planetary order. Now, when it first starts, you're probably going to need a pair of binoculars and definitely a clear view. But as the month goes on, you'll be able to start to see them with your naked eye. Now, astronomers are saying the best time to see this lineup is about 30 minutes before sunrise. So I figured if you're out partying late and you're one of those people who comes home right before the sun comes up, well, enjoy the view before you go to bed. You know, last time this actually happened was December of 2004. You know, now I'm kind of wondering, though, how is this planetary lineup going to affect our daily lives? Because we all know how crazy things get during Mercury in retrograde, right? Now we're going to have five planets to worry about? I mean, maybe it'll bring us all positive vibes, like new relationships, love, marriage, babies. Maybe I'm just rattling off my wish list. I don't know. What do you think? If you're into vampire movies, there's a new one that is coming out on August 12th on Netflix. Now, it stars Jamie Foxx and Snoop Dogg. Yeah, I know. That's pretty random, right? Well, it's an action comedy. It's called Day Shift, where the two guys are vampire hunters. Let's take a quick look.
Fox, you are not prepared for Day Shift. This is going to be like something you've never seen before. This movie has what I call eating popcorn moments. You know, when you're like, oh, shit. Oh, ooh. In this movie, I'm in the business of chasing down vampires and getting money for fangs.
Good energy, guys. Here it comes.
A good friend of mine, J.J. Perry, we started a stuntman together way back in the late 90s. Having done all the John Wick films and then reading the script, I think J.J. makes Day Shift a fresh take.
I love the idea of the vampires because it takes us up a notch.
Oh, no! No! Oh.
All right, we'll leave them hanging from this
JJ's
part.
J.J.'s taking we'll some vampire myth.
We'll cut it. Now, it also stars Dave Franco, Megan Good, and Natasha Liu, just to name a few. If you want to check out that entire trailer, you know where to find it, obvi. Or we might link it in the bio below, or the description below. Speaking of Netflix, there is a new animated Ghostbuster series that is in the works. Now, we all know how big that cartoon series was back in the 80s. And they even had a late 90s spinoff called Extreme Ghostbusters. But now, this new one's going to be coming out. Now, we still don't know what the plot details are or exactly when it's coming out, but at least we do know we have a childhood favorite to look forward to seeing. Can't wait. My favorite was always the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. I always wanted to just take a bite. I don't know. I just love sweets. I'm sorry. Talk about random luck, okay? This woman who lives in Michigan said that she was in line with her husband waiting to pay for gas. And this stranger came up to her and said, you should buy a $30 lottery ticket. I bet that you will win $4 million. So she ended up taking their advice. She went back to the car, scratches off the scratch-off ticket, and it was a $4 million winning ticket. Now, clearly, the couple didn't believe it. They checked it. They rechecked it. And then they realized they actually won this money. So who was that person? Was that a psychic? Was that God in human form? How on earth did this most random thing happen? And why can't things like that happen to us? I mean, I don't know about you, but I feel lucky when I find a dollar on the street. I once found $20 on the street. So I guess that was a really lucky day for me then. But I haven't stumbled upon a random few million, that's for sure. Walking around New York City, I might stumble upon a dead body. That's my biggest fear. Anyway, moving on. Little food topics for you. Pogi, hot damn, right? I know. That's crazy. Crazy. You want to be best friends with that person. I want to be best friends with that person. You know what? I'll be the babysitter for that person. Just give me some of that money. So let me ask you this. Have you heard of beefalo? Make sure you remember that name because it might just be the meat of the future. It's a cross between cattle and buffalo. So basically, it's the lean meat of a bison, and it's easy to raise and breed like cattle. Now, apparently, it's got lower cholesterol, less fat, and fewer calories than regular beef, okay? And it's all about crossbreeding. That is just crazy. I don't know. What are your thoughts on that? Would you be down to try a beefalo burger, too? I mean, any amount of ketchup can make that thing taste good, right? Leave your comments for me. Let me know. Beefalo. But no, it's beef, and then it's A-L-O, no, not two L's, but beefalo. Yeah, that's crazy. But I wonder what it tastes like. If it tastes like a burger, like I said, the right amount of ketchup can make it taste good. Slap that on. I'll eat it. Yes, New York does have some crazy things going on, Eco. Yes, yes, yes. XX Sunny, you would not have the beefalo burger. I mean, what if there was some cheese on it and some ketchup and some pickles and some lettuce, tomato? I don't know. What I'm about to share with you is pretty cheesy, no pun intended. But for some reason, Velveeta cheese seems to think that people want to take that cheesy smell with them through the day. Okay, they teamed up with Nails Inc. and they created not one, oh no, two cheese-scented nail polishes. Now, they come in yellow and red, and they even specify in the description, while our polish is cheese-scented, it is unfortunately not made of Velveeta. Please don't eat it. Who would want their fingers smelling like cheese? I mean, I'm sure there are a lot of things that are cheaper than $15 that you could stick your fingers in and pull them out of that might even resemble that funky smell you're looking for. Thinking about it, I feel like I need to barf. This is disgusting. Sweet cider, you wonder what vegans think of this? Well, I'm pretty sure that I could tell you they're probably pissed. And once they hear about it on this show, they're going to really be pissed. I don't know. I'll probably get some angry comments, but they can't be mad at me. I'm just dishing the dirt. That's it. Letting you guys know. Anyway, that wraps up our show. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel so you could join us live again next week. Also, if you are on TikTok or Twitter, find me at Starr, AKA Virtual. Hit that follow button, okay? And don't do anything I wouldn't do because otherwise I might talk about it next week right here on Hotish. Yes, cheese-scented TC Just. I know, disgusting. I know, XX Sunny, no cheese fingers. That's, I don't know. Why would you want to have cheese smell on your fingers? You know what it had me thinking? Like, what if you were trying to be cute with your boyfriend and you go to like squeeze his face because you just want to give him a kiss and he smells your cheesy fingers? He's going to think you're dirty. But maybe that just goes on in my head. I don't know. I was just thinking to myself, I wouldn't want anyone smelling my fingers and thinking they smell gross. Of course, TC Just, that is my job. Always spilling the tea. You know, I always got it for you every single week. But yeah, I want to give a big shout out to everybody who's in the chat right now. Thank you guys so much for joining. I've seen some new faces in here and I'm really excited about that. So thank you, thank you, thank you. If you didn't chime in the chat, feel free to say hi now before I get off because I want to see who's in here and I just want to say hi. You know, I like to have everyone hanging out and chatting and I want to see what part of the world you are from. Sweet cider. They should make butter scented ones and then you can call them butterfingers. See, there you go. You are a marketing genius and that would be fine. But although butter doesn't really have a scent, so it'd have to be like brown sugar butter or something, you know, something like that. So it's nice and sweet or sugar cookie butter. I don't know. Maybe that's why I don't do marketing. Yeah, next is Doritos nail polish, TC Just. You got that one right. And then, but the problem is then people are going to start licking your fingers. I don't want people randomly licking my fingers, let alone sniffing my fingers. Thank you, Leo. I'm looking forward to having you. Make sure you're subscribed. Subscribe, tell your friends, tell them to join. Oh, and guys, another thing too, we have a couple of really cute shorts on the page. So after you leave the chat, if you could do me a favor and jump on to my main page and go check out the recent shorts that were posted, show it some love, leave it some comments, pass it along to your friends, okay? Because I want you to go check out the Cardi B one. That one, that was my favorite. I'm still laughing over it. So if you want to get a good laugh, go to the Cardi B short that we posted earlier today. Check that out. Leo, you're from Trinidad. Oh my gosh, that is awesome. You must have some amazing weather. You must lay out on the beach all day. And I am jealous. Maybe I'll come. I have to get myself a bathing suit. And then I'll, you know, because I can't come, you know, laying in this. It's too hot. This jacket, I'm like dying. All right, with that said, let me head out of here. We're going to go. Thank you guys so much for hanging. I will see you again next week. Have a good one. Bye.